So over the next couple of months, we're really in this sort of final posturing and positioning by the United States to try to assert itself. On the North Korean side, the North Koreans have made it very clear that there is no space for negotiations that are dependent upon a rollback of the nuclear and missile program. And they intend to complete this program sometime in the next 18 to 24 months. On the U.S. side, they've made it very clear, particularly to the Chinese, that they cannot accept the North Koreans completing this program and having a demonstrated capability of striking the U.S. mainland with a nuclear weapon. Now, there's many who would argue that traditional deterrence will prevent the North Koreans from ever using that weapon, that they know that that would lead to their destruction and therefore they wouldn't ever utilize the weapon. But I think the greater fear from the United States may be not that deterrence fails, but that the failure to stop the North Koreans from developing this system starts to unravel the U.S. alliance and partnership structure around the world, and that leads to a greater strategic weakening for the United States. In other words, the South Koreans lose faith in the United States as someone who can protect them and secure them. The North Koreans maybe start taking truly provocative action towards South Korea, shelling islands again, sinking boats, maybe re-carrying out infiltration exercises, just to demonstrate that the United States is not willing to risk U.S. cities to protect South Korean strategic interests or national interests. And so that starts to unravel the perception that the U.S. really does protect its allies or its partners, and that unravels U.S. security in other parts of the world. I think that's the deeper fear for the United States than the more acute concern of a probably a highly unlikely North Korean nuclear strike on the United States.